This is George Jessel. Surely you know that Abel Green and Joe Laurie Jr. wrote a book called Show Biz, and they covered it all from vaudeville to video. Many lives are in that book, my own included. And as you listen to this album distilled from the book, see how much of your life is caught by Show Biz as a performer, a writer, a manager, or as a member of the audience.
I'm Jimmy, that well-dressed man. I'm a better man than Dapper Dan. Now here's a suit I bought for $33.50. Feel this piece of gabbity, boy, ain't it nifty? Yes, I'm Jimmy, that well-dressed man. Now deny that if you can. Deny that if you can.
That was the song Jimmy Durante sang as a singing waiter on the Bowery in Coney Island.
How do you do, sir?
Is this the office of Dr. Cronkite?
Yes.
Are you a doctor?
I'm a doctor.
I'm Dubious.
I'm glad to know you, Mr. Dubious. Mm. Mr. Dubious, am I invading? I got another patient in the other room. I'll be right back.
All right.
Oh, doctor. You butcher.
That's all I want to know.
Here, where are you going?
I'm going home. I forgot something.
What'd you forget?
I forgot to stay home.
Uh-huh, running out on the doctor, hey?
Better than being carried out.
And those were Smith and Dale, masquerading once again as Dr. Cronkite and his patient.
My father thanks you. My mother thanks you. My sister thanks you. And as for myself, that goes without saying.
That was the actual voice of George M. Cohan giving his famous curtain speech. All this goes back to the first 10 years of the 20th century when vaudeville was king and over 25,000 performers were working in 4,000 theaters. Managers lured audiences into their houses with slogans like absolutely free, one baby. What did it matter if it turned out to be one baby pig? And Willie Hammerstein packed them in with freak acts like phony pashas, acquitted murderesses, and the world's worst singers, the Cherry Sisters. A top star of the day was Blossom Seeley, immortalized almost half a century later by a Paramount Picture biography who had everybody singing Toddling the Toadalo.
When you talk, talk, toddling toadalo, toddle, 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 and away you go, that tune rippling round my ear. Each note and honey dear. Oh, listen to the piccolo and oh, just listen to the fiddle. As round and round, round and round, they go toddling, waddling, toddling. Two-step, that lovely new step. Oh, honey, that two-step. Run and tell the man, tell the leader man not to dare. Don't dare stop that plan. Come on, come on and let us talk.
When vaudeville was king, movies were called chasers, a chaser being something to chase the audience out so that the theater could refill with new customers. Thus, the movies became the last act of the vaudeville bill, a bill that might have included Lillian Russell, or Weber and Fields, or Al Jolson, or this great star.
Roaming in the gloaming on the bonny banks of Clyde. Roaming in the gloaming with my lassie by my side. When the sun has gone.
In 1911, an audience waited until after midnight for a ship delayed in the Atlantic to arrive from Glasgow. And when the great Scott finally embarked and arrived at the theater, he held them in their seats until 3 a.m. with his own special brand of songs and humor. His name, Harry Lauder.
With my lassie by my side. When the sun has gone to rest, that's the time that we love best. Oh, it's lovely roaming in the gloaming.
Show business is a business of names. Anna Held, who sported a beauty mark and took milk baths in a tub lined with mink. Lily Langtry, who asked that a carpet be spread from her dressing room to the stage. And because the carpet was red, that started the custom of rolling out the red carpet. Sarah Bernhardt, who insisted on being paid $1,000 a day in gold pieces only. Fanny Bryce, who was one of the first burlesque greats, when burlesque was a family theater with wives and children welcome. The first song she ever sang was Lovey Joe, but the song that made her famous came years later, and here's her original recording of My Man.
Oh, my God, I love him so. He'll never know. All my life he's just despair. But I don't care when he takes me in his arms. The world is bright. All right. And what's the difference if I say I'll go away when I know I'll come back on my knees someday? For whatever my man is, I am his forevermore.
And now listen to the actual voices of Nora Bays and Jack Norwood.
Turn off your light, Mr. Moonman. Go and hide your face behind a cloud. Can't you see that troubles want a true man to his company and freeze
you might as well have a thousand people standing around the rubbing wing room.
They sang about the moon at a time when Gus Edwards was presenting his school days, with performers you still remember a third of a century later. Groucho Marx, Hildegard, Ray Bolger, Helen Menken, Walter Winchell, Georgie Price, Eddie Cantor, and yours truly, Georgie Jessel.
One bright and guiding light that taught me wrong from right I found in my mother's eyes. Those baby tales she told, that road all paved with gold, I found in my mother's eyes.
In mid-century, there were over 2,000 millionaires, as contrasted with 200 in 1911. When Irene and Vernon Castle started the boon in novelty dancing, Gilda Gray and B. Palmer followed with the shimmy. Mae Murray and Clifton Webb. Did you know that he was a society dancer before he was Mr. Belvedere? Oh, yes. They did the tango. And Daryl Dina somehow blended a Broadway nightclub to the South Sea Islands when she popularized the hula by dancing it at Reisenweber's restaurant in New York. And while the nation danced, one man watched it all and discussed the topics of the day. He was Will Rogers.
Now, folks, all I know is just what little news I read every day in the papers. Everybody's talking about what's the matter with this country and what the country needs. What this country needs worse than anything else is a place to park your car. What our big cities need is another orange in these orange aid stands. I'm off Ireland for home rule from now on. I read an Irish paper the other day and it says liquor is 18 cents a quart. Can you imagine a nation wanting more freedom than that?
Florence Ziegfeld kept bringing Will Rogers back to his follies year after year, and Rogers was a hit as usual. The year was 1914. By this time, the First World War had started. In England, they were singing It's a Long, Long Way to Tipperary. In America, they first sang, I didn't raise my boy to be a soldier, but that changed to I'm proud to be the mother of a soldier boy by 1917. Oh, how I hate to get up in the morning. Katie and Hinky Dinky Polly Voo became pop hits. And Over There by George M. Cohan developed into an unofficial anthem, much as God Bless America did 25 years later. Lillian Russell, Douglas Fairbanks, Mary Pickford, William S. Hart, and Jack Dempsey sold war bonds. And thinking of more peaceful moments, Earl Carroll and Enrico Caruso wrote a song together called Dreams of Long Ago, and the great Caruso recorded it.
Dreams, just dreams of long ago, dreams of days that we both know. Time can never help us your many dreams until the last. Summer's gone and life grows cold. Still in dreams your mind of all. Heart may break, but you can't those golden dreams of long ago.
As the war was ending, John Wanamaker's, a department store in Philadelphia, transmitted phonograph record music to John Wanamaker's store in New York without the use of wires. It foretold the coming of a great new segment of showbiz radio. When the First World War was over, a door seemed to slam shut, and another seemed to be thrown open, to which impatiently tumbled a blare of jazz that turned the 48 states into one giant playground. The roaring 20s had started, and was to go up into an era of wonderful nonsense. Through the open door came flappers in short skirts, raccoon coats, hip flasks, rumble seats, and the Charleston. And the mood, the rhythm, the theme was jazz, as given out by the original Dixieland Jazz Band. Ted Lewis was there, too, in his battered top hat.
Is everybody happy?
And while the trombones laughed, the star who was to be the first and the last of the Red Hot Mamas sang Some of These Days, Sophie Tucker.
Some of these days, you'll miss me, honey. Some of these days, you're gonna be so lonely. You'll miss my hugging. You're gonna miss my kisses. You're gonna miss me, honey, when I'm far away. That I feel so lonely for you only. Cause you know, honey, you've had your way. And when you leave me, you know it's gonna grieve me. Gonna miss your big fat mama, your mama.
There was jazz aplenty in the era of wonderful nonsense, but it was Paul Whiteman who made a lady out of jazz with a concert at Aeolian Hall. There he introduced The Rhapsody in Blue by George Gershwin, and you are now listening to the original Whiteman recording.
Thank you.
That was George Gershwin himself at the piano. But this great event at Aeolian Hall had not been Gershwin's debut. Oh, no. He had already paved his way to fame with a song called Swanee, which he wrote with Irving Caesar and Al Jolson sang to glory. And here is Irving Caesar singing his great song as Jolson himself might have done it.
Swanee, how I love you, how I love you, my dear old Swanee. I give the world to be among the folks in D-I-X. I even know my mammy's waiting for me, praying for me down by the Swanee. The folks up north will see me no more when I get to the Swanee shore.
If you walked down Broadway during the 20s and looked at the lights on the marquees, you'd see No No Nanette with songs like Tea for Two by Vincent Newman.
Picture you upon my knee, just tea for two and two for tea.
Rosemarie, with songs like this one by Rudolph Frimmel.
When I'm calling you,
The Blue Room from The Girlfriend by Rodgers and Hart.
We'll have a blue room,
a new room for two rooms.
And a show that seemed as if it would run forever, The Desert Song, with Sigmund Romberg melodies, including One Alone.
One Alone.
Say, wait a minute. There was one more called Whoopi, and the star, Eddie Cantor.
Another bride, another June, another sunny honeymoon, another season, another reason for making Whoopi. A lot of shoes, a lot of rice. The groom is nervous, he answers twice. It's really killing that he's so willing to make Whoopi.
In the roaring 20s, Earl Carroll had his vanities on Broadway. George White had his scandals. And Florence Ziegfeld was glorifying the American girl to the music of Irving Berlin. Ziegfeld, his was the magic name. And here is a member of the original Ziegfeld Follies Company of 1927, exactly as he sounded in 1927. Franklin Bauer singing a song from the Ziegfeld show of that year.
I'm living up in the clouds, chasing a rainbow of a girl. In the air up there to screen us, nothing but the stars and Mars and Venus coming between us. I'm happy up in the clouds, chasing a
while the musical sang out, the films of the 20s were still silent, except for background music played by an organ right in the theater. Silent movies with very audible theme songs became a vogue. We watched What Price Glory with Victor McLaglen and Edmund Lowe and Dolores Del Rio and listened to Charmaine. Lilac Time was accompanied by Janine. Peg of My Heart took its theme song from the title of the picture. There was Ramona. And from Seventh Heaven with Janet Gaynor and Charles Farrell, there was Diane. Mary Pickford, Jackie Coogan, Charlie Chaplin, Rudolph Valentino, Gloria Swanson, and Rin Tin Tin were the stars of the silent silver screen. And then in 1928, a miraculous thing was added to movie magic. I, Georgie Jessel, had starred in a Broadway play called The Jazz Singer, and the Warner Brothers made it into a movie with Al Jolson. In it, Jolie gave the movies a voice. The jazz singer might be called a singy, since only songs were heard. But spoken dialogue and talkies were on the way. And it was Jolson again who broke all records in a talkie singy called The Singing Fool. Paramount followed Warner's with musicals like The Love Parade and Love Me Tonight, in which a great star was brought from Gay Paris to Hollywood, Monsieur Maurice Chevalier.
Oh, me, 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 me. You funny little good for nothing, me, me, I'm a good guy, me, me. You sunny little honey over, me, me, I make me high, me, me. You've got me sad and dreamy, you could free me if you'd see me, me, me. You know I'd like to have a little son of me, me, I'm
About that time, MGM joined the parade of movie musicals with sound. It starred Bessie Love and Charles King in Broadway Melody. This is the voice of Charlie King.
Don't bring a frown to old Broadway. You've got a clown on Broadway. Your troubles there are out of style. But Broadway always wears a smile. A million lights, they flicker there. A million hearts beat quicker there. No skies are gray on the grapevine way. That's the Broadway melody.
If you examine the era of wonderful nonsense very carefully, you'll find all kinds of contrasts. The ukulele was a fad. Flaming Youth sang of Barney Google.
Barney Google, 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 yeah. Barney Google, that white thing I desire.
And Helen Kane, the Boop Boop Badoop Girl, sang songs like
Ain't you kind of glad? Ain't you kind of gay? When you hear me say I love you, tell me, baby, ain't you? Boop, boop, baby.
Yes, We Have No Bananas was number one on the hit parade. There were marathon dance contests, flagpole sitters, the black bottom. But for all the love for crazy people and crazy tunes, a sentimental ballad and romantic voice teamed up to make the all-time best-selling record. Gene Austin, My Blue Heaven.
When Whippoorwill calls and evening is nigh, I hurry to my blue heaven. I turn to the right, a little white light will lead you to my blue heaven. A smiling face, a fireplace, a cozy room, a little nest that nestles where the roses bloom. just Molly and me.
Yes, in this era of wonderful baby nonsense, the two opposites in mood and tempo could live side by side. The Roaring Twenties kept many out late, but also kept many at home before that new thing called radio. The little magic box out of which came the voice of Wendell Hall, the red-headed music maker.
Wow, 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 wow.
Wow, 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 wow.
Jimmy had a nickel and didn't have it long. Didn't have it long, cause the kids found out that Jimmy had a nickel. Jimmy had a nickel, Jimmy had a nickel, Jimmy had a nickel.
Vaughn DeLeith.
See each little one with his stardust gun join a rockabye parade. And before you know, they'll go on tiptoe where another dream is made. So hug me tight and put out the light, cause you're marching unafraid. With a great big yawn, you'll toddle on in the rockabye parade. Good night.
And the Happiness Boys, Jones and Hare.
We two boys without a care entertain you folks out there. That's our happiness. Just to know the things we do make us feel we're pleasing you. That's our happiness.
Each one beneath the sun should know that he's done his share while he's here.
Spreading all around him a little sunshine and cheer.
If we failed, at least we've tried.
Radios changed from crystal sets to beautiful cabinets with built-in antennas. Everything was becoming bigger and better. Opening night tickets for Earl Carroll's Vanity sold for $100 each. The stock market was going up. And up. And up. And then... Black Tuesday, October 29, 1929. Variety described what happened in its headline, Wall Street Lays an Egg. The stock market crash changed our tune to Brother... Can you spare a dime? The big boom became the big bust. The unemployed sold apples, two for a nickel, on street corners. Bonus marches went to Washington, and the party was definitely over, for a time anyway. One facet of showbiz, however, as if tailor-made for the Depression, grew up and prospered. It was free and came right into your living room. Radio. In towns and cities, the nation paused each night at 7 to share the adventures of the Fresh Air Taxi Company, Amos and Andy.
Eyes regusted.
Owa! 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 Owa!
There was Ed Wynn, Fred Allen, the Goldbergs, George Burns and Gracie Allen, Joe Penner.
You nasty man!
Fibber McGee and Molly, Jack Pearl.
Was you there, Charlie?
There was a new star named Bob Hope. And one night, a fellow who claimed he was looking forward to his 39th birthday stepped up to the mic to play his fiddle. Jack Benny. And one comedian had the largest radio audience of all. Only the King of England abdicating his throne to become the Duke of Windsor, and Franklin Delano Roosevelt's declaration of war drew more people to their radio sets. His name, Eddie Cantor.
We want Cantor, we want Cantor.
There was Morton Downey.
Wabash moon, keep shining on the one who waits for me.
And And will you ever forget?
Elsa, and now the time has come to lend thine ears to au revoir, pleasant dreams. Au revoir, pleasant dreams. Think about when requesting your theme. Until next Tuesday, when possibly you all may tune in again. Keep the old maestro always in your scheme, Yelza. Au revoir, this is Ben Burney, ladies and gentlemen, and all the lads, wishing you a bit of pleasant dream.
There was Rudy Valley, the vagabond lover.
For I'm just a vagabond lover, in search of a sweetheart, it seems. And I know that someday I'll discover her, the girl of my vagabond dream.
Arthur Tracy, the street singer.
Martha, rambling rose of the wildwood, Martha, with your fragrance divine.
And one young fellow who introduced a new boo-boo-boo-boo singing style that topped them all, Bing Crosby.
Just a gigolo everywhere I go. People know the part I'm playing. Paid for every dance, selling each romance. Every night some heart betrayed. There will come a day, youth will pass away. Then what will they say about me? When the end comes, I know they'll say just a gigolo as life goes on without me.
During this era, Helen Morgan brought tears on Broadway.
More than you know,
while Bee Lily brought laughs.
When the moon is stealing up behind the hill, I get such a funny feeling. I can't keep still. I get again professing, so I'll very soon be getting over to the old oak tree, where I love my loving lover, like he likes me.
And Jimmy Durante, taking the advice of Sime Silverman, founder of Variety, broke up with his two partners, Clayton and Jackson, to go west and do a single in Hollywood movies. No wonder the great Schnozzola sang,
I know darn well I can do without Broadway, but can Broadway do without me? Herald Square, Times Square, Columbus Circle, 96th. Say, where am I? I must have passed my station. When they found out that I passed my destination, everybody says, Durante, let's have a celebration. As I get off the express, some yokel pushed me into a local. The crowd seen a mistake, pulled the emergency brake and shouted, that's Jimmy, that well-dressed man. Now I know darn well I can do without Broadway, but can Broadway do without me? Yes, sir, can Broadway do without me?
Hollywood was hit by the Depression on one side, the changeover to sound on the other. But despite the upsurge of the talkies, the movie palaces still needed bank nights and automobile giveaways to lure the customers in. Variety told a story in a headline, Sticks, Nicks, Hicks, Picks. Yes, Depression America wanted movies, but only the best, and Hollywood met the challenge. Walt Disney gave us Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Marie Dressler and Wallace Beery created the roles of Min and Bill. Clark Gable and Claudette Colbert romanced in It Happened One Night. We howled at Charlie Chaplin again in City Lights and blushed as Mae West whispered, "Come up and see me sometime." David O. Selznick gave us Gone with the Wind, the biggest hit of modern times. And there were such great film musicals as Warner Brothers' Gold Diggers of Broadway.
We're in the money, we're in the money. We've got a lot of what it takes to get along.
42nd Street with Ruby Keeler.
Come and meet those dancing feet. On the avenue I'm taking you to, 42nd Street.
The Wizard of Oz with Judy Garland dreaming wistfully.
Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby.
And there was that Dancing in the Clouds couple, Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers. The top composers wrote for them. Vincent Humans gave them the carioca from Flying Down to Rio. Irving Berlin set them dancing cheek to cheek in Top Hat.
Heaven, I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak, but I seem to find the happiness I see when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek.
Jerome Kern offered them a perfect lover's serenade.
Lovely to look at, delightful to know, and heaven to kiss.
And Cole Porter created one of the most memorable moments as Astaire and Rogers danced and sang in the Gay Divorcée. Incidentally, here is the rarest of all recordings, a record by Cole Porter himself. He plays and he sings, too. One of his greatest songs, You're the Top.
You're the top. You're an arrow collar. You're the top. You're a coolie scholar. You're the nimble tread of the feet of Fred Astaire. You're an O'Neill drama, you're Whistler's mama, you're Camembert. You're repose, you're Inferno's Dante. You're the nose on the great Durante. I'm just in the way, as the French would say, de trop. But if, baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top.
Astaire and Rogers sent America to dancing, but soon a different beat began to emerge. A different dance step, a different kind of music. It was called swing. That was the era of the great bands. You've just heard the original recording of In the Mood by Glenn Miller. But there were others who made the music go round and round. Tommy Dorsey.
Oh, I blow through here, the music goes round and around. Whoa, 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 whoa. And it comes up here. Now you push the first valve down, the music goes down and around. Whoa, 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 whoa. And it comes up here.
Cab Calloway.
Folks, here's a story about Mindy the Moocher. She was a red-hot hoochie coocher. She was the roughest of his frail, but Minnie had a heart as big as a whale. Ho dee ho, dee ho,
ho dee ho, dee ho.
I dee hi, dee hi,
I dee hi.
And the king of swing himself, Benny Goodman, playing his own clarinet.
Mm-hmm.
1939, the World's Fair opened in New York. Mike Todd presented Gypsy Rose Lee. Billy Rose staged the Acrocade. I brought little old New York back to the fair. And that same year, a Brazilian bombshell named Carmen Miranda made her Broadway debut in the streets of Paris. This is what she sounded like.
Have you ever danced in the tropics? And not hazy, lazy, like, kind of crazy, like, South American way. Have you ever kissed in the moonlight? And not grand and glorious, again, notorious, South American way. The Latin scheme of love is like a dream of love. A Latin stream of love is in their veins. They'll buy a jewel for you, or fight a duel for you, or drive a mule for you across the plains. There is melody in their music. While the gauchos sing it, come on and swing it, the South American way.
But all the news from other lands wasn't as cheerful as Carmen Miranda. Good evening, Mr. and Mrs. America, and all the ships at sea. There's very grave news tonight. Nazi troops have invaded Poland. The rumble of those marching feet echoed round the world. Newscasters, Ed Maurer and Edwin C. Hill, H.B. Kaltenborn and Elmer Davis, Raymond Gramswing and Walter Winchell, Eric Severoid and William L. Shira were heard with new attention. But as the march and the invaders grew louder and louder, here at home, a chorus of patriotism began to swell. Irving Berlin set it to words and music. Kate Smith sang it. And in our hearts, we all joined in.
And the mountains, through the prairies, through the ocean, wide with love, God bless America, my pink.
1940, the bugles blew, and America shook with a frenzy that was a combination of wartime prosperity and the fear that tomorrow would never come. The people didn't say it, but they thought, enjoy yourself, it's later than you think.
Enjoy yourself, it's later than you think.
But soldiers fought, and soldiers in grease paint entertained them. Dinah Shore brought a breath of home into the front lines overseas, and to hospitals where the wounded lay. Francis Langford, Bob Hope, Al Jolson, Catherine Cornell, Arlene Francis, Gracie Fields, Kay Kaiser, Joan Davis, Bing Crosby, Joey Brown, Cantor, Jessel, Durante, all made tour after tour. And Jane Frohn and Gypsy Markov lived to come back from a plane crash off Lisbon. Paradoxically, the foe's favorite war song became ours as well. Especially as interpreted by the incomparable Hildegard.
Would you like to hear the story of a girl that many soldiers know? It's a tale of love and all its glory they tell when the lights are soft and low. Underneath the lamppost by the barrack gate, standing all alone, every night you see her wait. She waits for a boy who marched away, and though he's gone, she hears him say, oh, promise you'll be true. Fare thee well, Lily Marley, till I return to you. Fare thee well, Lily Marley.
Oh,
Unsere beiden Schatten sahen wie eine aus. Dass wir so lieb uns hatten, sah man gleich daraus. Und alle Leute sollen es sehen, wenn wir bei der Laterne stehen. Wie einst Lele Marlene, wie einst Lele Marlene. Fare thee well, Lily Marlene.
In New York and in Hollywood, G.I.'s danced with Betty Davis, Marlena Dietrich, Dinah Shaw, and all the other glamour girls at the stage door canteens. Morse Hart produced Winged Victory for the Air Forces. And there was another show called This Is the Army. That show raised $10 million for Army Emergency Relief. Baston, Hiroshima, and finally it was over. And as we reconverted to peace, strange gadgets began to appear on American rooftops. Milton Berle became everyone's Uncle Milty. Hopalong Cassidy wrote again. Television brought everything, Dagmar, wrestling and panel shows into the living room. But the reigning kings of showbiz, both as impresarios and creative writers, unquestionably were Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein II.
Oh, the hummer where the wind comes sweeping down the plain, and the waving wheat can sure smell sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain.
We started with Oklahoma, wrote and produced such tidbits as Carousel, Allegro, John Loves Mary, The King and I, Me and Juliet. And then in South Pacific, a basso from the Met became a wow with the Bobby Soxers, Ezio Pinza.
Some enchanted evening, when you find your true love, when you feel her call you across a crowded room, then fly to her side and make her your own. Or all through your life you may dream all alone. Once you have found her, never let her go. Once you have found her, never let her go.
Yes, that was Ezio Pinza himself. During this period, as people were flocking to Broadway to enjoy those great productions, a voice on phonograph records was commanding a greater and a greater audience. The man to whom the voice belonged had started as a recording artist in the early 40s, and he was to enter the 50s as the undisputed champion. His name, Perry Como. You know his later records. Now listen to the first record that he ever made.
Goodbye soon. All the best of luck to you. You've been my only gal, what's more, my best pal. Please don't cry, smile until the clouds roll by. Don't kiss me, dear, just walk away, or I could never, ever say goodbye, goodbye soon.
People stayed at home to listen to Como on an old invention called the Victrola, and to see him on a new invention called TV. But with all the staying at home, Broadway was booming. Even two-a-day vaudeville revived as the Palace presented Judy Garland, whose performance touched us all. Then Betty Hutton, and then Danny Kaye.
Dinner. Is there anyone finer in the state of Carolina? If there is and you know her, show her to me, oh, Dina. With her Dixie eyes blazing, how I love to sit and gaze in to the ease of Dina Lee. I know that every night, why do I shake with pride? Because my Dina might change your mind about me. Oh boy, it's a happy showbiz album, Dina. If she wanted to, Gina, I would hop an ocean liner just to be. Give it, give it, give it, give it, give it, get it, get it, get it, give 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 it.
The cradle of showbiz, Vaudeville, came back for an encore.
Encore! Encore!
Throughout the years, showbiz has proved one thing. There is nothing as permanent as change. Ah, we've seen the change from ragtime to jazz to swing, radio to television, silent movies to talkies to technicolor to three-dimensional films. But the more things change, the more the pattern remains the same. Yesterday's John McCormick gives way to Johnny Ray, Lillian Russell to Rita Hayworth, Caruso to Lanza, Chaplin to Sid Caesar, Laurel and Hardy to Martin and Lewis. The stars change, the shows change, the songs change, but showbiz goes on, giving one encore after another. And when Eddie Fisher sings, as he does right now, he is an encore of great performers of the past who have moved on and who have left their place for him to fill.
They're not making the skies as blue this year. Wish you were here. As blue as they used to when you were near. Wish you were here. And the mornings don't seem as new, brand new as they did with you. Wish you were here. Wish you were here. Wish you were here. Someone's painting the leaves all wrong this year. Wish you were here. Why did the birds change their song this year? Wish you were here. They're not shining the stars as bright. They've stolen the joy from the night.